who bitted you? Somebody bitted you.
Huh? Somebody bitted you.
I know.
I saw him coming, he came right to me. He left the middle of the field.
Wow.
Yeah. He's the only one that came, like nobody else thought it was time to come in or anything. It wasn't like a mistake. Facing more than to present the saddle. If I was facing this way, it would have been confusing, but I'm not facing that way. So I need him to recognize that that's not, I get it, it's coming to me. Good. But right here is where he's supposed to come to. Good. That's why I was telling you, because often you'll, come back. Because you'll stand aside and call the horse from a different direction. You won't realize that by standing sideways, you call the horse to where you're facing. So you always have to try when you're mounting off, or always stay facing the way you want them to come to you. Where they, because if they set up and you were facing that way, they didn't get any wrong. Good job. Good job. Good job. Hold on.
reason there's any problem. Yeah, the alarm's going off.
Yeah.
That would have sucked.
It's vibrating.
Vibrating and singing and... What a good boy you are. Yes, you are. You go for me.
Thank you.
versus they'll say, I make the plan to get on them. Well, I make the plan to try, but I don't make the plan to do it no matter what. In his case, I didn't plan to do that much. So
we did grab any expectations today. I was just wondering, like, we typically do that, you know, sideways like that for a week or two?
It depends on the horse. Sometimes I'll do that 3 times before it feels natural to slide right off.
Do they ever react negatively once you put that leg over? Or do they, by then are they pretty used to it?
He progressed pretty quickly through being scared, not knowing what to do with his feet, to follow instructions to go forward. I'm sorry. I didn't mean to like hang on there. I didn't want you to go over that. So, like, he's basically telling me that he could be, you know, a riding horse next time. You know what I mean? He likes me to trust me now.
Yeah.
So, that's a plus. Some horses I'll jump on the first time they rush up doing that. I'll probably ride them off a couple times. I honestly a lot of times do it based on how long they're racing horses. I mean, I find that happy. Say I'm getting on because I can't do it that way anymore. But they still need the education. I don't start them with a saddle because I'm not confident that I can climb out of a saddle when something goes wrong the same way I can just slide off that. So I break all my horses to that. Usually why they'll throw themselves into a buck. Usually any bucking I get is more like a kick out. I'll see the bucking with the saddle on, you know, my first saddle for the first time. Then I try real hard not to let them do that again. First time's free. The first time I saddle them, then sometimes they'll bronk out, they'll like go full with noises and everything.
Yeah.
You know?
What can you do if he has that?
There were a lot of things about it he didn't understand that he was afraid of. So now, I mean, he still, you know, kind of said, I'm not sure about that today. You know, he's not 100% about it, but he's trusting that I'm not trying to hurt him. But usually if they throw the buck in with the first time with the saddle, then I try to do whatever I can to see what works on the ground to help them through that. So often it's pushing them forward. So like a horse that starts bronking out, it's because they're kind of stuck in one place. So if you push them forward, they have to move their body to get out of the buck. They can't buck when their whole body's stretching out. So, and it's the opposite of what you think control. But no, you want them to get going. Forward is your friend. Still is not, you know, a horse that sucks up and stops is a scary horse to ride. He's got forward, he got confused, but he moves forward, you know. So I'm not that worried. I mean, if he bucked, it's just, I mean, he rounded up the first couple times with, I think he rounded up with the saddle on. He definitely rounded up the first time I used that. So the potential was there to buck, so I know that that's his first spot. He does, even when I'm on him like that, he's very light in the front. His front becomes very tall. So that could lead me to believe that he's going to be one that rears instead of bucks, which is still ugly. You know why I don't? It's because you wearing those joints out. So that's why I don't lay down. I mean, my horse will roll kind of on command, and then go with some of as he did earlier. But it's just because I'm conditioned to know that's what it's about. It's just what I'm doing. And then rearing, like I said, I can't guarantee somebody's not going to come up to my horse and, you know, flip my hands up back. Like, you know, there's a couple trainers that use whips. You know, people walk around from the rear or something. They don't know. There was a guy at one of the barns that I was at that used to teach people's horses. It wasn't his job, it wasn't his bike. Thought it was cool that he could do it. Well, that's great. Now that people don't know the horse knows it. It's horrible. Why do it? So.
Now here, no one's allowed to touch it.
Yeah, well, yeah, and I'm the one that handles the horse, so why don't I?
Yes.
she passes away, Mrs. passes away, I don't know if things are gonna happen, but mom still has the rights right now. So, once mom's passed away, she's 85. So, and then I'm gonna be yeah, he saw me coming, nobody else moved. He was far out, he was one of the farthest ones out, and he saw me, came right to me. And then the girl who owns Lennox, she's like, he was waiting his turn. Here's every time anybody moved, he came and looked, he'd see if it was gonna be his turn. So like he likes having something to do. Yeah, when I first met him, the most disconnected person I've ever seen in my life. He looked like you were invisible, right to me. We would never